हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 10 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर 10 सर्कल्स। दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 4। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी एग्जांपल 1 2 एंड 3। सो एग्जांपल 1 इज प्रूव दैट इन टू कॉन्सेंट्रिक सर्कल्स, दिस वे टू कॉन्सेंट्रिक सर्कल्स वी हैव, दिस बिगर सर्कल इज C1 एंड द स्मॉलर सर्कल इज C2। Concentric circle, that means you know the center will be the same, so center O is the same for both the circles. The chord of the larger circle, this AB, is chord of larger circle C1, which touches the smaller circle, and this chord touches the smaller circle C2 at this point, is bisected at the point of contact. This chord is bisected at this point of contact B. That means AB is bisected at the point B. That means AP equals to B. That is what we do. So in solution, first we write the data, what is given. The two concentric circles are here with C1 and C2 with center O, and a chord AB of the larger circle C1 which touches the smaller circle C2. Smaller circle C2, it touches the chord of this larger circle at the point B. This chord touches the smaller circle at the point B. To prove, we want to prove that at this point of contact, this chord is bisected, means AP equals to BB. This we want to prove. So the proof is, first let's join OP. To prove this, we will join this OP. So by broken line we have shown it, and then if we join this way, the AB is a tangent to C2. This AB is the line which is intersecting the C2 circle at only one point. So it will be the tangent to the smaller circle C2. So AB is a tangent to C2 at P, and OP is radius. OP is radius, AB is tangent. For that relation, you know, radius will be perpendicular on the tangent. Theorem 10.1. So OP perpendicular AB, that we have seen, we have proved. Now for bigger circle point of view, C1, AB is a chord. Now for a while you don't see the C2, the smaller circle, just you see the big circle C1, larger circle C1. For that AB is a chord, O is a center. So OP is the perpendicular drawn from center to the chord. In 9th standard we were having the theorem that if perpendicular drawn from center to the chord, it bisects the chord. So that is here, AB is a chord of the circle C1. As the perpendicular OP from center O bisects the chord AB, because OP is the perpendicular drawn from center to the chord, then this OP perpendicular to this chord bisect the chord. That's theorem we have seen in 9th standard. By that we can say that OP is the perpendicular from center to the chord AB, therefore it will bisect the AB, and if the AB is bisected, then you can understand AB equals to PB. So this is very simple proof we have. Example 1. Example 2 is, two tangents TP and TQ are drawn to a circle with center O from an external point T. Let the circle is given with the center O, an external point T is given. So from external point you know that two tangents can be drawn. So they are TP and TQ, two tangents are drawn from the external point T to the circle of the radius O. What to prove? To prove that angle PTQ, this angle is twice of angle OPQ, this angle. When this angle is double of this angle, angle PTQ is twice of angle OPQ. This we want to prove. So in solution, again we will write the data. What is given first, we will note that. So here we have two tangents TP and TQ from an external point T to the circle with the center O. Right? So that's why points P and Q are points of contact, you will say. पी एंड क्यू आर पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट. पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट मीन्स द कॉमन पॉइंट ऑफ द रेडियस एंड द टेंजेंट. सो दिस इज ऑन दिस साइड पी, ऑन दिस साइड क्यू. पी एंड क्यू आर पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट. टू प्रूव वी वांट टू प्रूव हियर दैट एंगल बी टी इक्वल्स टू टू टाइम्स एंगल ओ. टू प्रूव दिस लेट एंगल बी टी क्यू, बी टी क्यू दिस एंगल वी हैव कंसिडर्ड एज थीटा. As you know, angle can be considered as any alphabet also, but here we have a theta for the angle measure. Angle BTQ equals to theta. And one more thing, you know, from the external point, the tangents are, two tangents are drawn to the circle and they are equal in theorem 10.2 we have seen. So this DP equals to DQ, you can write. If DP equals to DQ, two sides are equal for this triangle BTQ, you can understand. If two sides are equal, it is isosceles triangle. And that also we know, if two sides are equal in triangle, then opposite angles are also equal. So because TPQ is an isosceles triangle, the side opposite to TP is angle this Q, TQP, that is, because so TQ it is, so its opposite angle will be, TQ's opposite angle is this angle, that is TPQ. DQ equals to DQB, DPQ, because our DPQ is an isosceles triangle, right? So these both the angles are equal in this triangle, that we have understood. Now, angle TQP is equals to angle DPQ, both the angles are equal. So if you want any one angle, suppose TPQ point of view to talk about, sum of all three angles is 180, you know, these two angles are equal. So from 180, if I subtract this angle, I will get the sum of these two. And sum of these two in that these two angles are equal. So any one angle will be half of the sum because they are equal and the sum. So TPQ equals to one angle, this angle will be equals to half of 180 minus this angle. Half of 180 minus theta, half of 180 is 90. Minus half of theta can be written as theta by 2. Also, angle OPT is 90 degree angle because it is the radius and TP is the tangent. And radius is always perpendicular on the tangent at the point of contact. Theorem 10.1, you know, that we have used. OPT is 90 degree, full angle is 90 degree. And this part is given, TPQ. This angle is 90 minus theta and the whole angle is 90. To get this part angle, what we do, angle OPQ, this part angle equals to whole angle OPT minus this angle TPQ. We will do. Dramatically, you can see the figure very carefully. Angle OPQ in this angle equals to the whole angle OPT minus this part angle TPQ. Now place all the values, just angle OPT is 90 degree, we place minus TPQ is here we have 90 minus theta by 2, that we have placed. Now open this bracket, 90 minus 90 minus minus plus theta by 2. Here 90 degree plus and 90 degree minus we can cancel this way. So we have meaning theta by 2. Theta by 2 can be written as 1 by 2 theta. And 1 by 2 theta means we have considered as PTQ. So this is 1 by 2 PTQ. This 1 by 2 PTQ is the answer of angle OPQ. Therefore, this by 2 upon 2, if we take on that side, it will be multiplied. And here we will have angle BTQ equals to this 2 is taken to the multiplier of this 2 times angle OPQ. So this way, hence the proof we got. Angle BTQ equals to 2 times angle OPQ. Right? Example 3, next we have. PQ is a chord of the length 8 cm of a circle. This is the circle given with center O. PQ is here one of the chord, you can understand, you can see here, of 8 cm total it is shown here. Of radius 5 cm, if I join this O to P, this is radius and it is of 5 cm given. The tangents at P and Q, tangents are drawn. continue.
Here, PQ is a chord, OP is a radius, chord of 8 cm given, radius is 5 cm given. At P and Q, two tangents are drawn from the external point T, so that is TP and PQ. Two tangents are there. We want to find out the length of this TP only. So, to solve this, the solution is join OT. First, we will join OT. So, it is shown by a broken line. Now, joining this way, you can understand this OT will be perpendicular on PQ. And it is perpendicular, it is intersecting the OT, intersecting PQ at R. This we will say. We have taken as assumed OT perpendicular on PQ. It is obvious, you can understand, right? So, OT bisects PQ, that also we know. Here we have root from the center to the perpendicular to the chord, bisect the chord. So, OT is from the center to the chord, it is drawn perpendicular. So, it will bisect the PQ. Therefore, PQ is bisected in two parts, PAR and RQ. So, PAR equals to RQ equals to half of PQ. Half of PQ, PQ is 8 here. So, half of 8 is 4 cm here. Now, in triangle ORP, triangle ORP, angle R is 90 degree here. So, in triangle ORP, Pythagoras theorem we can use. We can get this RO or OR. So, OR square equals to hyper square OP square minus PR square we can write. So, if we take the direct value of OR, in root we have to write OP square minus PR square by Pythagoras theorem. So, root of OP means pi square minus PR means 4 square, that is we have. 5 square 25 minus 4 square 16. 25 minus 16 is 9. Root 9 means 3 centimeter we have as OR. Got it. Now we will see the triangle TPR. In this triangle you see carefully. All the sum of 3 angles is 180, you know. Angle TPR, this angle plus angle PTR, this angle plus angle TRP, this angle. All equals to 180. So angle TPR as it is plus angle PTR as it is plus angle TRP. TRP is 90 degree, you can see, obvious it is. So 90 equals to 180. So therefore angle TPR plus angle PTR equals to 180 minus 90. 180 minus 90 will be 90 degree, see result 1. And also, you know that angle OPT is also 90 degree because it is the radius OP on TP tangent. Radius is always perpendicular on the tangent on the point of contact P. So, OPT plus OPT equals to 90 degree and OPT, angle OPT in that two part angles are there, angle TPR plus angle RPO. So, OPT full angle is equals to the sum of angle TPR plus angle RPO and OPT equals to 90 degree. So these two are 90 degree angles given. So from 1 and 2 we can equate them on the left side because the right side are 90 degree. We can equate them. Therefore angle TPR plus angle PTR on the left side of result 1 equals to left side of result 2 is angle TPR plus angle RPO. Now this, in this angle TPR on both the side you can cancel. So what is remaining? Angle PTR here equals to angle RPO here. So angle PTR equals to angle RPO we have. And one more thing, that angle TRP equals to angle PRO. You can see here TRP is 90 degree and angle PRO is also 90 degree angle. Now these two shows, this two, what we have shown actually. If you see the triangle TRP and the triangle PRO. Two angles we have shown equal in that, both the triangles. In TRP this T angle and in this PRO, P angle, here we have shown equal, one angle. The second angle are TRP and PRO 90 degree, therefore they are equal. So if we have shown the two angles in the two triangles equal,
So we can say that both the triangles are similar by EE criteria, angle. We have shown two angles of these two triangles equal. So therefore triangle TRB similar triangle BR by EE criteria. If two triangles are similar, their sides are in proportion. So we have shown that sides are in proportion. So third side TP equals to upon third side PO. Here we can write equals second side RP upon second side RO. We can write that is sides are in proportion. We have shown. Now place all the values. TP as it is TP. PO is 5. PO is 5 given equals RP. RP. Here we have RP as or PR 4 that we have placed. RO. We have found R, that is OR equals to 3, that we have placed, all the values you place. So therefore TP equals to this 5 down will be on multiply side on 4. So 5 4s are 20 upon 3. So 20 upon 3 centimeter is TP. That is only we wanted to find. Find the length of TP. So TP equals to 20 by 3 centimeter is very nice. So after doing example 1, 2 and 3, we have the next as exercise 10.2. So it is your homework to solve exercise 10.2 and complete the chapter. Thank you.